So gonna do a little bit of a quick and simple video. As you can probably hear, my voice not feeling the greatest today, but want to make sure to still share this, and I didn't want to wait. I wasn't greatly anticipating this PSA order, so really looking forward to this. This is our second economy order. So Joe and I sent a bunch of cards out. We've got 20 cards in here. Again, hopefully all of them are graded. Pretty big box for 20 cards. So we'll see what it looks like inside, but really happy that it's in. We will use the big guns again, so you guys don't have to see me struggle. Hopefully I don't struggle too bad getting into this puppy, but you know, I've never opened a PSA box of this size, so wish me luck, I guess. And Joe would be very happy. I'm cutting away from myself. I usually do that faux pas of cutting towards myself. Not safe, but trying to be safe. All right, there we go. We are in there. And hopefully we don't, hopefully we open from the right side. You know, I don't like to show the grade before we get in there. Two boxes. One is significantly lighter than the other one, so I think we'll go with the lighter one first, and then we'll go into this one. You see here, it's got the economy. You know, so it was about a month to get it all done, and that's a great turnaround. Expecting 60 days when they sent this out. So let's bust right in. It says one of two, two of two. Maybe we'll go in the order that they're suggesting. Go with the first one first. That should be the order that we sent them in, right? All right. So let's go from this side first. And I'm trying to remember which cards are which. All right. So this one, okay. This one, before we get into this one, I'm pretty sure I know which one this is. This one should be the black label Jordan. So before we get into that one, I had cracked that out. So here's the flip. That it's an old flip that I had cracked it out at. It was a PSA 9 beforehand, but it's a black label. They mislabeled it as a gold label, and I noticed a little bit of, you know, some dirt and stuff. So I figured I'll clean it up a little bit, wipe it down with a fiber cloth, and you know, I'm assuming it's going to get a 9, which is good anyway if I just got it reholdered. But maybe getting it clean and getting rid of that dirt, it could get a 10. So, you know, hoping for the best here. But if we get an 8, I'm going to be sorely disappointed. We got a 9. Okay, so that's what we expected. So good. And they did label it correctly with the black label. It's always good to review your order, make sure that, you know, they have it labeled the way that you expect it to be. Next one we have here. The Vince Carter got a 9. Okay, so this was the first day issue refractor of Vince Carter. And I'm happy with that grade. Very happy, in fact. So this is one that, you know, I think authentication goes a long way with a card like this, numbered 225. You know, so I think I know where we are in the order. But, you know, really hard to put a value on this. I didn't talk about the value of the black label, but I'll show you based on what Card Ladder says. You know, this one is extremely hard to put a value on. Haven't seen any copies sell, you know, at all, really. So happy with a 9 on that one there for my PC. Here we got the Penny first day issue. This one got a 10. Oh, wow. That's awesome. I am pumped. Again, this is another one. You know, it's a PC item. I've got two copies of this card. I have the other copy in a separate order. You know, so I have, you know, I've loved this set for a while. No idea the value on this, a 10 on that. Boy, I'm hoping for more good news from this order. All right, here we've got a 9 on the Fleer tradition of electrifying. We've got two in this order. I've sent away a Iverson before, and that one also got a 9. These are really, really tough to get 10s, but very valuable if you can. 9s are very difficult on these as well. This one should be the next one, and this one also get a 9. So I've heard some people speculate that if you send the same card in and they're around the same type of condition, that they'll get the same grade. You know, that's speculation. But these ones definitely looked about the same for condition. So having 2 9s, definitely, definitely happy with that, because it, you know, an 8's a bummer on those for my. Okay, so here we've got a Steph Curry rookie. So we've got 2 Steph Curry rookies in here. A little bit of suspense here. This is the Prestige. You know, Steph Curry in the playoffs. We'll see if my wife will even let me sell this card if it comes back in a higher grade. But you know, I was hoping for a 9 on this card, and we'll see how it does. Got a 9. All right, very happy with that for the Panini Prestige. There are a few of these. You know, and again, I'll probably flash the values up there, but when I sent it away, I think I was targeting like a $300 price point for this card. And I think a 10 is probably like 500, 600, 700. So you know, again, take a look at Card Ladder. That's where we'll find out. This should be, oh, my Planet Metal penny. Got a 9. Very happy with that. These are very difficult to grade, so very, very happy to get a 9. You know, a lot of PC stuff in here that you know, kind of experimental. Okay, so here we go with the Kobe. Again, this is another one that I cracked out, so giving you all kinds of suspense. I said it's gonna be a short video, maybe not. So this one I cracked out. It's a gold label, so you know, before you see that, but it was a 6, and it had some sort of, it almost looked like somebody put tomato sauce on the front of the card. So I wiped that down as much as possible. It's not completely gone, but it's better than it was. So you know, I bought it, I don't remember when I got it, but it was a while ago, and it was less than a raw copy. So I figured if I clean it up, maybe it'll get a 7 or an 8. You know, Kobe card values aren't doing great right now, so not really sure how this is gonna do for me for value. When I sent it away and I was saying, hey, let's target an 8, it was about $140, $150 card. I think right now, it's probably about the same. I'd have to check. So we'll see what the grade is. Again, I'm hoping for a 7 or an 8 on this. I don't want a 5, but certainly better than a 6 is what I'm hoping for. It got an 8. All right. Very, very happy with that. You know, so you heard the story there. I'll take a look at the values, but extremely happy with an 8 on this card. These ultra cards do not grade well. And like I said, with that issue there, you know, right now looking at it, I can't even see. Like, I know where the issue was, but it's not as easy to see anymore for sure. All right, this next one here, we've got the other Curry rookie. I've already got a 9 of this one. So let's see if this one did. I sent away which one I thought was better first, which is a while ago when it was like $20 to send away. So we'll see if this one, if I chose wisely or if this got better. This one got an 8. Okay, so I did choose wisely. So, you know, again, have to look at the value. I really love the Studio Rookies, or the Studio set. When it came out, I remember buying as many packs as I could find at Target. Not that I was chasing Steph Curry. I don't think many people were at that point in time. But, you know, mainly LeBron was the guy that my brother and I were trying to pull. So, you know, an 8 here, nothing that's going to blow our socks off. But having a duplicate, keeping the 9 for my wife, she might let me let go of the 8. We'll see. All right, here we go. I've got a couple PMGs. So here's the first one. This one got a 6. And again, you guys know with the PMGs, you really want to see something that has got authentication. And that's the case here. So the grade is not really that consequential for the value. It's really just getting it authenticated. The next one should be another PMG. And this one also got a 6, which makes sense. They both had similar issues with surface. But again, authentication is the key on this. So just wanted to get those slabbed. Didn't really care what the grades came back at. This one should be a PMG Championship. And this one got an 8. Wow. Okay. Very nice. I mean, these ones definitely do grade better than the reds and the greens. So very happy to get an 8 on that, though. Oh, another PMG Championship, I think. I keep forgetting. This one got a 6, okay? So that makes sense. And I'll probably keep one of these and sell one. I'll probably sell the 8, in all honesty, and keep the 6. But, you know, again, authentication is the goal for those. All right, here we go. Oh, this is my Josh Allen Gold. This is a thick slab. So this one I actually got as a gift for winning our fantasy football league 2 years ago, a year ago. I can't remember when it was exactly. So, you know, this was thanks to Joe for this card, and Joe actually had the suggestion you should probably grade it and see what it's worth. So Joe's hoping that this gets a 10. I was projecting probably a 9, but maybe an 8. I mean, really hard for me to know because there's very few of these graded at all. This one got a 9, so very happy with that. Like I said, I've never been a huge fan of these thicker slabs. You know, the card is thicker, so I get it, but yeah, that's available for sure. All right, I think we've got a couple of Joe's cards coming up here. So we got a 9. All right, so this is the Aqua Wave. I know Joe's got 4 or 5 cards in this order. I think he's hoping for 10s on as many as possible, but I think he'll be happy with a 9 as well. Here's another one of Joe's, 9 on that as well for the orange refractor. And I don't know these players. Joe knows soccer. I do not. So maybe you do in the comments. This one is a thick one too. Oh yeah, his Kaboom got a 10. Wow. All right. He's going to be pumped. He is going to be excited about that. Kabooms don't typically grade well from what I know. Not the biggest Kaboom fan here, but yeah. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, we've got a green label. Oh boy. Like I said, I think, I'm not positive that these are Joe's cards, but maybe one of mine slipped in there. You know, again, I'm failing to remember what is what. So let's just go in order here. All right, so another Kaboom, same one actually, Joe pulled both. Both got a 10! I like that, Joe. I like that for him very much. Very happy for him. 2 10s on those 2 Kabooms that he pulled. All right. So what do we have here? Do not holder. Wow. So I got this card in a trade. And apparently it's not legitimate. So I'm going to have to go back to the person, you know, because I traded away quite a nice card, and he traded me 2 of this same card. And if they're saying that this is not authentic, yeah, not thrilled at all about that. Trying to keep my temper to a minimum here. All right, so this I think is Joe's Carly Lloyd. Got a 10. I know he'll be happy about that. So, wow. All right, so, you know, one big disappointment with the LeBron. Very, very displeased with that. But the rest went pretty well, so that's what we got.